Okay, good morning children. What is second year? English medium. First chapter continuation. What is the first chapter learning? Transport in plants. First chapter continuation. Transport in plants. Transport in plants. Okay, in this first chapter, last topic, flow and transport from source to sink. Flow and transport. Phloem transport. Phloem transport from source to sink. From source to sink. Phloem transport from source to sink. So, what is source? Source is a part of a plant where the food was synthesized. Especially leaf. Or what is sink? Sink is a part of a plant which can utilize the food, which need food or which store the food. All the storage parts are called sink. So especially in phloem, the movement of the direction of the movement is bidirectional. Especially in phloem, bidirectional movement. Bidirectional movement. Bidirectional. But what is the bidirectional movement? In phloem, the food is transported to upper parts and lower parts. So that type of the direction is called bidirectional movement. Whereas in xylem, the water transported only in upper parts. So the movement of the water in xylem is unidirectional. 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 Okay, the movement of water in xylem is unidirectional. The movement of food in phloem is bidirectional. Bidirectional. Okay, unidirectional and bidirectional. And one of the particular the scientist Munch, he explained about the bidirectional transport in phloem. So that is that we called pressure flow or mass flow hypothesis. That is called pressure flow. That is called pressure flow or mass flow hypothesis. Pressure flow or mass flow hypothesis. That is pressure flow or mass flow hypothesis. It was proposed by the scientist Munch. Munch. Pressure flow or mass flow hypothesis. But what is pressure flow or mass flow hypothesis? Especially the mechanism which is very helpful for translocation of substances, translocation of glucose from source to sink is called pressure flow or mass flow hypothesis. Especially the mechanism which is very useful to understand the translocation of sugars from source to sink is called pressure flow or mass flow hypothesis. So here, especially you know, glucose which is prepared in the leaf by the process of photosynthesis, the glucose is converted into sucrose, then the sucrose is moved into the, first the sucrose move into the companion cells. First the sucrose move into the companion cells, then after the sucrose move to the phloem side tubes, then the sucrose moves to the phloem, phloem sieve tubes. Then the sucrose moves to the phloem sieve tubes. So whenever the sucrose moves to the phloem sieve tubes through active transports, there should be hypertonic conditions are created. So water which is present in the adjacent xylem that moves into the phloem, here osmotic pressure is developed. Due to osmotic pressure, the phloem sap move to the areas of low pressure, especially the sink that should be, that should having very low concentration or low pressure. So and again active transport is necessary for movement of the sucrose into the phloem sieve tubes. These sucrose from the phloem sieve tubes that can enter into the other cells. The cells, by utilizing these sugars, the cells they can produce energy and they can produce starch and cellulose. So whenever the sucrose moves out of the phloem, the pressure is reduced. Water which is present in the phloem that moves out of the water moves out of the phloem. So finally, from the source, the sucrose is entered into the sink. So this type of the translocation is called pressure flow or mass flow hypothesis, which was proposed by the scientist Munch. This is also called Munch hypothesis. So with the help of diagram, we clearly explained about the hypothesis. But what is the diagram? Once you can see here. Here you can see Nani. Here you can see Nani. This is the pressure flow or mass flow hypothesis, which was proposed by the Munch. Here you can see Nani. So this is the xylem. Here you can see phloem. Okay, here this is the pure water. Pure water. Here this is the source. Here this is the sink. Here this is the dilute solution. Here this is the concentrated solution. Okay, so here so children, so this is especially pressure flow or mass flow hypothesis by Munch. Here you can see clearly, here this is the source where the food was prepared. Source means here leaf where the food was synthesized. So from here the food means the glucose, here synthesized, the glucose is converted into sucrose. Then the sucrose move into the companion cells. From the companion cells it moves to the living phloem cells. This leads to hypertonic conditions. Because of these hypertonic conditions, water from the adjacent xylem that can enter into the phloem. So because of this increasing of osmotic pressure, the phloem sap moves to the areas of low concentration. Here the zinc that should be having very low and low concentration. So again another active transport is necessary for movement of the sucrose out of the sieve tubes. So from here the sucrose is moved to the cells by using the sugar. They can produce energy, starch and cellulose. So this is the one of the hypothesis which was proposed by the Munch, how the sucrose is transported from source to sink. So this is the pressure flow or mass flow hypothesis which was proposed by the Munch. So this is the diagrammatical explanation. Okay, next this is the diagrammatical explanation then. And next so here you can see so the translocation of sugars. This diagram shows the translocation of sugars. This diagram shows the translocation of sugars. Here you can see. You can see now. You can see clearly. This is the root, this is the leaf, this is the tip of stem. So from here, from the leaf, sucrose moves into the sieve tubes. Sucrose moves to sieve tubes. cytotubes. Water flows by osmosis. Water flows by osmosis. Here also, sucrose. Sucrose moves out of cytotubes for metabolism and storage purpose. Sucrose moves out of the cytotubes. Sucrose enter into the roots. Here you can see. Here also same. Sucrose moves out of the cytotubes. Cytotubes. Okay. Water flows by osmosis. So from source, this is the source leaf. From source, where the food was prepared. From the source leaf. So from here, the food is transported into stem regions. The food is transported into root regions. So upward movement and downward movement. So this is called bidirectional transport of the phloem. So that here the phloem transport the synthesized food here stem regions, root regions, upward direction and downward direction. So this is called bidirectional movement. Okay. So this is about the phloem transport source to sink. So children, today we completed the first chapter. Tomorrow we are going to start second chapter. Okay, thank you, children.